हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दी कैडकैम सी लेक्चर सीरीज। दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द कंपोजिट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस। सो वील हैव अ लुक एट फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स। सो दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल प्रॉब्लम। सो दिस इज अ ट्रायंगल गिवन, रोटेट ट्रायंगल पी क्यू आर अबाउट पॉइंट क्यू बाय 30 डिग्रीज। सो पी क्यू आर ट्रायंगल इज गिवन with coordinates P as 3,8, Q as 14,6 and R as 8,5. The first and important thing is the rotation that we have to carry, okay, is not with respect to the coordinate origin but is with respect to this point Q, that is 14,6, and the rotation angle is given as 30 degrees. Since it is given positive 30 degrees, the rotation is expected in counterclockwise direction. So these two things are very important. So once we know what is required, so the first thing we should always do is generate the object matrix. So the object matrix is generated in a sequence P, Q, R. So the first coordinate is in a column representation. So first column is for coordinate point P, the second column is for the coordinate point Q, and third column is for coordinate point R. And the sequence is, the first row in first column is going to be the x coordinate of point, second row is going to be the y coordinate, and the third row, since it is a homogeneous coordinates, will remain 1. So this is 3,8,1, that is point P, 14,6,1, that is point Q, and 8,15,1, that is point R. Okay, 1 is for the homogeneous coordinates. Okay, so my coordinates in my 2D Cartesian reference frame are only 3,8, 14,6, 8,15. Now, since we have to rotate this triangle with respect to Q by 30 degrees, the first step is I will have to bring this point Q towards origin. Okay, so I have showed this by arrow. So this is a back translation. This is a back translation. So what I will do, the transformation matrix, the new coordinate of the object or the new transformed coordinates of the object, I am writing it as T equal to, I will start from the extreme right. First I will write the object matrix. Then in sequence, okay, I will pre-multiply. Okay, the first operation is I will first have to make Q as origin. So in order to make Q as origin, I will have to translate it by minus 14 and minus 6. So minus 14 in X and minus 6 in Y. Okay, then my Q will become origin. Okay, Q will become origin. So this I call it as inverse translation or back translation. So translation inverse I have written, or back translation. So translation with negative translation coordinates. So that is why minus 1 is written. So as you can see, the matrix 1, 0, minus 14, 0, 1, minus 6, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so once my Q becomes origin, then I will rotate this triangle by 30 degrees. So I will write a rotation matrix for theta equal to 30 degrees. That is given as cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, then 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, and once my triangle is rotated by 30 degrees, I will again translate it back to the original position. So from origin to the current or the required location of Q, that is 14,6. So it is going to be a forward translation with positive translation coordinates. So it is 1,0,14,0,16,0,0,1. Eventually, I will have to multiply these four matrices. Now we know the multiplication law of the matrices. I cannot change the order, but I can multiply these two first, these two second, then I will write the answers, and then I will eventually multiply the answers and get the final answer. So in all, I will have to carry out three multiplications. First, I will multiply these two to get this matrix. Also, I will multiply these two to get this matrix. And at the end, I will multiply these two to get the final answer. So this is my final answer, somewhere around 3.474, 2.232. That is the new transformed coordinate of point P. Okay, 14,6 remains to be 14,6. Now why it remains to be 14,6? because we have rotated the triangle keeping Q fixed. The rotation happened about Q, and that is the reason why after I do all the matrix multiplications, how I am going to cross check? I am going to cross check with the help of the new coordinates of Q should also be equal to the old coordinates of Q, and the ultimate outcome is my Q is remaining fixed, so I cannot change the coordinates of Q. So Q remains to be 14.6, and the new coordinates of R become 4.304, 10.794. Okay, and of course the last row is for the homogeneous coordinates. So this was a very simple task. Okay, let us continue further and try to do the composite scaling. Okay, so the same triangle I have taken. So scale triangle PQR 3 times with respect to Q. So with respect to Q means again it is expected that Q will remain fixed. Okay, Q will remain fixed, and the scaling should happen keeping Q fixed. Okay, and see, normally scaling happens with respect to origin, and if the scaling factors are larger than 1, the object tends to move away from the origin, and if the scaling factors are less than 1, the object tends to move closer to the origin. Okay, but if it is with respect to some other reference point, okay, then we have to carry out composite transformation, and that is what we are going to do. So again I have object matrix on the extreme right hand side. Since again the Q point is to be kept fixed, okay, we will move Q to the origin. Okay, we will move Q to the origin. So the sequence of operation is always the new reference, okay, should be moved to the origin first, okay, then carry out the required transformation, again move the reference back to the original position, and find out the answer of all the matrix multiplication. So that is what the sequence is. So I have on the extreme right hand side the object matrix, okay, pre-multiplied to it the inverse translation or back translation. So I will translate point Q to the origin by writing 10 minus 14, 01 minus 6 and 001. Okay, then I will perform the scaling. Now it has been told that scale triangle PQR 3 times with respect to Q. So 3 times means they haven't given separate scaling factors for X and Y. Since they have only given us 3 times the original size, that means the scaling factors in both the axes are same. So that is Sx equal to Sy equal to 3. And that is what the scaling matrix I have written, 300030001. And then once it has been scaled, I will translate my reference, that is point Q, back to the original position. It will be a forward translation. So I have a translation matrix to multiply at the end, that is pre-multiply. So 10 14 016 001. Okay, I can carry out again multiplications in whatever sequence I want. I can multiply these two, then multiply this, then multiply this, or I can multiply these two, get the two resultant matrices, multiply them and get the final matrix. Okay, in any sequence you multiply them, you will have to carry three multiplications. So I have multiplied these two first, written this matrix, multiplied these two, written this matrix, and eventually I found out the resultant matrix. The resultant matrix comes out to be minus 19, 12, 1, that is the P, new coordinates of P are minus 19 and 12. Again, the cross-checking factor, Q coordinates are unchanged. Okay, so Q remains to be fixed. So Q remains 14.6, and R coordinates become minus 4 and 33. Minus 4 and 33. So what is happening? Since the size is getting increased by 3 times, so what is happening? P is getting transferred into the second coordinate, as well as R is also getting transferred to the second coordinate or second quadrant. Okay, now in second quadrant I have X negative and Y positive. So rightly we are getting X coordinates of point P as negative, that is minus 19, Y coordinate remains to be positive as 12, and for point R my X coordinate again is minus 4 and my Y coordinate is 33. So this was a very simple examples of composite transformations, how the transformations can be carried out if I change the reference of scaling and rotation other than origin. Okay, so the normal sequence is first bring your reference to origin So you have to reverse translate it or back translate it or inverse translate it. Okay, then perform your transformation, that is the main transformation, either rotation or scaling or reflection or some other transformation, and then again transfer your reference back to its original position. Okay, and while doing all these things, keep in mind object matrix has to stay on the extreme right hand side, and every transformation activity should be pre-multiplied to the object matrix in sequence. Okay, in sequence. So this is my first activity, this is my second activity, this is my third activity, and I have to pre-multiply every time, and the resultant will give me the new transformed coordinates of triangle PQR. So I hope you have understood this simple task. I will see you next time at the CADCAM CIE lecture series.